day has finally come. We're putting this dirt bike back together. So before I start diving into anything, I'm gonna mount foot pegs on here so we can strap it down to the scissor lift. Give you a quick view of all the parts we got laid out. So much hardware, everything. A couple other pieces and parts. Everything over here. So this is one of the items that I picked up from Revive Moto. Leakage set up in here. Put this little guy on here. All right, so my swing arm already got chain adjuster bolts, got the chain guide and then slider all mounted on there. As well, throw this chain all around here. All right, up in front of the bike here. Screw stem in there. Bearings that are degreased. Seal. Just get this top clamp finger tight so that we can now get the forks in there. This stem nut here, I believe it gets torqued to 108 newton meters, which is pretty much 80 foot-pounds. Go ahead and get the old handlebar mounts on here. Thank you. mount up this little steering stabilizer. Starts connected. One thing we gotta do with the brake lever, since it's, you know, pretty much non-existent, replace that. Thank you. plastics aren't half bad. This one's in a little rougher shape here. Piece of plastic here that I probably should have got. That was these fork guards because they're pretty much yellow. And I mean, the rest of the bike, yeah, the plastics are banged up and scratched up here and there, but at least they're still you know, vibrant, to say the least. But these are pretty nasty. Oh well, here's what it is. Now we gotta run around and torque down all these linkage bolts. The upper shock right here is 33 foot-pound. And then the lower shock mount is still 33 as well. This gets torqued down to 65 foot-pounds. Guy gets torqued down to 38, I believe. Same with this other linkage just above it. This thing looks good. Compared to my 2014 sitting over there, this one looks just as good here. Let's get some fluids in her here and maybe we can get her fired up here. So we're just about getting ready to fire things up. We need oil and gas. That's the only thing left, so. Transmission side, we got 580. Final thing we need, some gasoline. Well, it is all put back together, and it looks like a nice polished turd, if I do say so myself. I think I'm gonna wait to fire it up on camera. You know, leave a little bit of suspense here. Next video, I will probably be out taking it for a little rip, you know, barring any crazy weather. And then I'll also detail every single part and everything that that was purchased, and every single dollar that went into this bike. It's been a long day, but we made huge progress and got the bike done. So like usual, in the description below, all the affiliate links for any products that I really like to use, and you might have saw in this video. And then obviously the Patreon link. If you wanna go support the channel, you can head over there as well. Otherwise, a nice like on this video, a little comment down below what you think of the bike. Maybe you got a video of your 450 you want me to check out, just head down in the comments, let me know. And you know, as always, if anybody has any tips or anything, and they want to leave that there too, that's great. So other than that, I will see you in the next one. Peace.